So, having looked at the top 10 diagnoses and their split across males and females, let's dig a little deep and look at the top diagnosis, gastritis, and see what more insights we can find out for this top diagnosis. If you go back to our data, the last data set that we created, which was the patient diagnosis top 10 by sex, if you were to look at that data, we can look at for each of the top 10 diagnoses, it gives us a split of male versus female. Now, what we want to do is we want to go a bit deeper and look at for each of these diagnoses, what are the top city or the villages from where this has been reported the most. So essentially, if you look at it, we don't have the city or the village information which is present right now in this data. So we need to be able to bring that data back and get the split across different city or region. So that's the first thing that we are going to do. So if you look at this query, what we are doing is for each of the diagnoses, we are going to get the top 5 regions from where it has been reported the most. Don't go by the variable name top 3, it is actually top 5 regions. So what basically we do is we get the data which we have fetched from the database, which has the ops table information about the diagnosis. And what we do is we add the city and the village information which was not present in our last query, and we try to summarize the data based on diagnosis and it's split across city and villages and get the top 5 city and villages from where this each of this top 10 diagnosis has been reported the most. So if we execute this particular data, we can look at that we have 50 entries, which is for each diagnosis, there were 10 diagnoses. For each diagnosis, if we were to see, it gives us the top 5 cities where it has been reported the most. Now, we want to go a step further, and now we want to see for each city, what is the ratio of male versus female. So what we do is we take up this data and we try to again go to the original data that we fetch from database and then add the gender information and try to summarize this information along with the diagnosis and village. We also try to add the gender information. So once we add this information, we can see that this gives us the data that we are looking for, which is for each of the diagnoses, it gives us a split for each of the top 5 cities. It gives a split what is of male versus female. Now we are interested in the top diagnosis, which is gastritis. So, and we want to visualize the data. So what we do is we go back to our favorite plotting library, which is the ggplot. And what we do is we put a filter that we are only interested for the gastritis data. That's what this filter diagnosis equal to gastritis does. And what we want to do is we want to plot the top 5 villages or cities from where gastritis has been reported and order it based on highest to lowest and further split the bar based on the gender. So that's what this plot does. So if you were to quickly run this code, we can see that we get for each of these cities where gastritis has been reported the most. So if you see the city 1, city 2, city 3, everywhere it gives us the split of male versus female and the number of patients reported across this top 5 cities for gastritis. So that's the data regarding the top diagnosis that we wanted to look at. So having looked at that, we'll go a step further and see how does the age distribution of male and female looks in this top 5 regions. So far we have only looked at the bar chart. Now we will also see the box plot, which gives us the min-max data and also the central tendency of the age and also histogram. So let's quickly go and look at how to get that information. So to look at the age distribution, what we do is we take the original data that we have fetched from database and only filter for gastritis, since we are interested in looking at the age distribution for gastritis. And what we do is we get, and for the top 5 region, we want to look at how does the male to female age distribution look like. So we join the top 5 region based on the diagnosis and the city or village, and try to get the data which gives us the information on the patients for these top 5 regions, which we can further do a box plot on. So we'll execute this code, which will generate us another data frame, which will further contain all the patients, because since we want to do a age distribution for all these top 5 regions, it gives us the patients and their ages, which we can use further to plot. So far we have been using the geom underscore bar. Now to look at the age distribution, we will do the box plot. And what we are doing is we are going to add a layer called facet, basically to say that we'll have a split of this data across the genders, so that we can look at how does the age distribution look like. So we are saying that on the x-axis we'll have the city or the villages, and on y-axis the age distribution. And then what we do is we will flip it, since the region names are little longer or the village names are little longer, we end up making x as the age and y as the city village. So when we execute this code, let's see the data that it generates. So if you look at it, the age now is on the x-axis and the cities are there on the y-axis. So if you look at it, it tells us how does the distribution look like. The center line over here talks about the median or the central tendency for this city, and these dots represent the outliers. In general, in statistics, outliers are something which lies beyond the plus minus 1.5 times the interquartile range. So if this is the interquartile range, so basically this is where the 0th percent data is there, this is the 25th percent, this is the 50th, this is the 75th percentile, and this is the 100% percentile data. This box gives us the interquartile range. So whatever is there on the right side as 1.5 times beyond this are shown as outliers. Similarly, since age cannot be negative, we don't see any outliers on the left side of it. So, and the facet wrap that we added, it gave us two parts of this graph. One is for female, another is for male. So if you were to look at inside, we can see that on an average, the female age for the gastritis is around somewhere between 25 to 30 or 25 to 35. Similarly, for male, if you were to look at it, it is almost maybe a little higher if you look at it over here for city 1. But more or less, it does not look very different. So this gives us the age distribution. This plot is called the box plot. The same data can be visualized using histogram, wherein we can divide the ages into different bins. We have created bins where each bin shows us a 20-year age, and we say that we want to plot the same data which we used for plotting the box plot. And we say that we want to see how does the number of patients in each bin look like. So if we were to execute this data, we can see that this plot does not show us any outliers, but similar to the box plot, it also gives us the frequency for each bin. So if you look at it, for the 0 to, so basically we created 20 bins. So basically we divided the age range into 20 parts, and for each part we are showing the frequency over here and number of patients reported in that bin. So if you look at it, for city 1 we look at this age, which is around which is around between 15 and 20, which has the maximum number of patients reported for gastritis. Similarly, if you look over here for CT2, it also has around, at for the age group of 20 to 25, it shows us that it has the maximum number of patients. So this way histogram helps us looking at the number of patients reported for a particular group or a particular range of age, and we can look at a distribution of these patients across different age groups. So the same data which we viewed in box plot is viewed using histogram. Moving on, say we want to view the year wise and the month wise analysis of the number of patients reported for gastritis. So what we do is we go back to the ops table, and we are interested in the ops date time, because this ops date time gives us the date on which this particular diagnosis has been reported. And what we do is we extract the year part of it and the month part of it, because we want to see month by month distribution across multiple years. So we create two more columns which gives us the observation year and observation month, and then try to group that data to see how many patients have been reported for a particular year in a particular month. So if I were to execute this piece of code, you will see that we will get that for 2011 January there have been 194 cases of gastritis. Similarly, in 2013 in March there have been 783 cases. While this data we have, but it is better if we can visualize the same. So we'll go ahead and see if we can have a bar chart drawn, which will give us a quick insight on how does the trend look like. So what we do is we give the data which we have summarized, which is the year and month data of gastritis and how many patients have been reported for every year and month. And we say that the x-axis contains the month. And what we do is we want to add a facet for every year. So we want to see trend for every year across different months. So that's why we have added the facet wrap. So let's quickly see how does this data look like. So if you look at it, except for say 2016 and 17, if you look at it on an average, 2014-15 looks almost similar. Maybe initial few months looks higher over here in terms of the number of patients reported over here. In 2016, between say March to say August, the number of cases have gone up significantly. Similarly, in 2014, if we look at it, there is significantly higher cases in say May and June. So this kind of gives us the trend of the number of patients reported for gastritis over every year and each month in each of these years. So can we say, do we see any particular trend? This initial information does not seem to give us any particular indication. It might give us maybe some gut feel, but we can't say for sure that maybe in the summer between May to June, maybe the number of cases are higher, but we are not very sure. The data does not give us any particular indication or a particular trend. I mean, we can't say for sure that we can expect higher number of cases in a particular month every year.